I am Ananta Kumar. I am taking up fuel pump to teach the cadet. This is fuel pump, which is an important component to ensure smooth running of engine and also to develop high power. Now what we see is one pump is in fully assembled condition, the other pump is in knockdown state. Before going to explaining the functioning of each and every part, I just give you the general idea of the pump. As I have already told you, to ensure smooth running of the engine as well as to develop, the pump is used to develop high pressure, which is capable of developing even up to 1200 bar. It delivers fuel at right time and also the right quantity. All this ensures the pump engine, IC engine, to run smoothly as well as to develop the power, the proportion of the fuel what we supply to the engine. It is done, but the injection is done by the injector. The set pressure, according to the set pressure, the fuel is injected into the cylinder to the cylinder in a mist state through the fine holes in the injector. This is barrel. It has got spill port. Through the spill port, fuel enters the barrel. This is plunger. It has got two important things. One is vertical slot. The vertical slot is used to stop that engine. When the vertical slot comes in line with the spill port, as there is direct connection between delivery and the suction, as no pressure can be built up, engine comes to a stop. Slow speed and high speed, various speed is controlled by the helical movement of the plunger in proportion to the spill port. Quicker the helix comes into contact with the spill port, that is slow speed. Longer the time it takes, more fuel is delivered, it is high speed. The vertical movement of the plunger inside the barrel ensures slow speed and high speed. Now I am keeping my hand in erosion plug. This is ensure no damages happen to the pump body. When we stop that engine, we stop the engine according to our convenience. When we stop it suddenly, when high pressure oil comes back, when it comes to contact with the body, bodies tend to develop crack or erosion is very fast and swift. To reduce that erosion plug, tip take the impact of that high pressure and ensure body is not damaged. Normally, when you open the pump for inspection, its length has to be 20 mm. If it is less than 16 mm, it means it outlives its utility. You have to renew it with a new one. The other important part is delivery valve. It is ensure a non-return valve. When the high pressure oil is in the high pressure line, the oil should not come back. And also to develop high pressure, it also plays a part. This is delivery valve holder. This is spring. This is spring bottom seat. This is spring top seat. This is barrel lock screw. This is air purging screw. This is control rack lock screw. This is control rack. This is control sleeve. The movement of the control sleeve ensures the movement of the plunger inside the barrel, changes the position of the helical groove controlling the slow speed and high speed. Now I am going to box of the pump. I take the help of one of my colleagues.
Now let us see the assembly of the pump. In the body, the barrel is being inserted. You have to check up the location of the barrel where your locating pin can be inserted, and the barrel will be locked in that place. You can see that the locating pin will be locking the barrel in place. Now, from the bottom side, the plunger will be inserted. Now the barrel is in place. Now the pinion rack will be inserted inside. And this is the one which is going to regulate the plunger to increase the quantity or decrease the quantity. The rack and pinion is the most important one. We have inserted the rack. Now the pinion rack is being inserted inside. The rack is inserted inside and it is locked in place. This rack operates a pinion which turns the plunger, which operates the, which controls the quantity of fuel being increased or decreased. Now the pump is kept upside down. The control sleeve is being inserted inside, which has got a rack which is going to merge along with the pinion. There is a marking in the pinion which has to go along with the marking on the rack. Now the spring carrier is being put inside. The spring is being put inside. Then the plunger with the bottom spring carrier, it is being inserted. Care must be taken. The plunger has to go in the correct place. There is a slot in the barrel. The plunger peg has to go in the slot. Otherwise, it may crack. Now the plunger is in place, which is moving. The plunger peg is in the slot of the barrel. It moves free. The bottom cup, spring cup, is being put in place and it is being locked with a circlip. It has to be pressurized with the hand, not with any other external tool. The spring is pressurized and the circlip is put in place. The locking has taken place. Now the pump is kept straight. A delivery valve is put in place and delivery valve holder is put in place. Care must be taken while putting the delivery valve. The erosion plugs is put in place. The inlet banjo bolt is being fitted in place. Now the air purging plug is put in place. Now the pump is ready in assembled condition. The delivery valve cap has to be tightened to the required torque. The delivery valve is fitted in place and the cap nut is in place, and that cap nut has to be tightened to the required torque. Now the pump is ready for putting it in place.